Dr. Prabhakar Koreji, who is my senior colleague in the Parliament of India and also the Chancellor of KLE Academy of Higher Education and Research and also the Chairman of KLE Society. Dr. Shiva Prasad S. Gowdaji, the Convener of the Organizing Committee and Research Coordinator for this Women's and Children Health Research Unit. Dr. Vivek Sawji, the Vice Chancellor of this prestigious university. Dr. Mrs. Niranjana S. Mahanta Shetty, the Chairperson of the Organizing Committee and also the Principal of this prestigious college. Dr. V.D. Patil, Registrar. And we have a long list of guests of honors. In fact, in my last 25 years of public life and almost 3-4 decades of my association with the profession, I don't remember any function of such great repute where I can see so many VIPs, each one of them an institution in himself or herself. And all from various parts of the world. In fact, it's a privilege for me to be part of this very august gathering of intellectuals on the stage. Dr. Chandrasekhar, my colleague in Government of India, Additional Director General in ICMR, Dr. A. Vishmaiya, Dr. Mark L. Tykonsinski. I'm sorry, I'm not talking about the huge designations that you possess because of the limitations of time. Dr. Joshua Vogel, Dr. Tonse N. K. Raju, Madam Mary Ellen Stanton, Mr. R. Justin Brown, Dr. Naveen Rao, Dr. Richard J. Derman, Dr. B. S. Kotkani, Dr. Vivek, I think I already mentioned, and then we have this very august gathering where we have senior faculty members, researchers, academicians, vice chancellors of other universities, and people from international agencies. And I am so happy that we have participation from World Health Organization, an organization where I worked for almost a decade as an advisor, also from Eunice Kennedy Shriver National Institute of Child Health and Human Development, Global Network for Women's and Children's Health Research, and other NIH agencies, UK Medical Research Council, Department of Biotechnology, that's my own department in the Government of India, Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, American Academy of Pediatrics, Thresher Research Fund and Merck for Mothers. It's a very great galaxy of great people from great institutions, not only in India but from all parts of the world, and more particularly from the developed world and from all the UN organizations. So I think the first thing that I wish to do is to congratulate Dr. Prabhakar Kore and all his team for the great effort that they have done. I think they certainly deserve a big applause from you. There are very few occasions when even in Delhi so many people will come for an international conference, leaving their own work in prestigious places all over the world. And the other fact why I need to congratulate him is that, you see, he has given me the privilege of coming here In fact, since the time I got in touch with him in 2014, when I assumed the charge of Union Health Ministry, he had been after me and he wanted me to come to this institution when I was Union Health Minister. So in November 2014, I was asked to take another responsibility, science and technology, earth science. Later on last year, environment, forest and climate change also got added to it. But I am so grateful to him that he kept on pursuing with me for the last 4 years also while I was in the science and technology ministry. And it was probably my bad luck that I had to wait for this particular day. And this today also, it has been possible because the speaker announced a holiday in parliament. And he had been asking me for last 2 months that you have to be here on 26th. But because today normally I have a question hour in Rajya Sabha, so it was virtually impossible to come here. But then God had been kind to me. And I think this is a great institution. I had heard about it, but for the first time I had the privilege to see and had a glimpse of it in the last 1 hour or so. As a thanks to those visionary seven Saptarishis who almost 100 years back thought of dedicating their life for the cause of education. And I don't think that there is any other society or any other trust in India which may have grown up to this extent that in almost 100 years they have around 300 institutions related to higher education, medical field, engineering, etc., etc. Not only in Karnataka but all over the country and even in Dubai now. And all this particular medical college, which is also quite old, if this showcases what the others are doing, then I think they are really the state-of-the-art institutions. And I'm so happy to be here in a very, very good medical college, being a doctor myself who has seen my own medical college. Of course, I also had a alma mater which had a very beautiful building, but I think this institution which has developed over the last many decades, I think you have maintained it quite well, and certainly there are a lot of things for others to emulate. And being an environment minister, I am also very happy to see that there is all this green activity, green movement which is strengthened in this institution. So all my heartiest congratulations, and especially the fact that you not only talk about giving opportunities to women or for women empowerment, but you try to create a model here. And then today also the subject that has been taken up for this international conference, this is some of those some of the very passionate areas for which I have always enjoyed working. I joined politics in electoral politics some 25 years back in 93, and my first responsibility was to be the health minister in Delhi. And there when we started a lot of movements along with the polio eradication movement, but one of the very important things that we did was for the first time create a social movement around the Safe Motherhood campaign. And we started a Matri Suraksha Abhiyan, whereby on the 10th of every month, there used to be over 600 places in the city of Delhi where we'll create everything to educate mothers and to ensure that all those mothers who don't go to the system to take care of their antenatal activities, etc., they are brought into the system. And there used to be a movement whereby almost 50,000 pregnant women who will never go to the organized system, they would be caught in that. And that movement became so successful that I still remember, fondly remember, that in 1998, on the World Health Day, the WHO, with its Director General Dr. Nakajima, he declared safe motherhood as an international day, and he made it a point to come to New Delhi and inaugurate at a place in Yamuna Vihar, eastern part of New Delhi, in the presence of 2,000 pregnant women, along with our great Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee, that safe motherhood campaign for the whole world. So it has been a very, very passionate area for me, and I'm so happy about it. And then, of course, about the newborn, you know, that one of the last programs that I did in the Health Ministry was to launch the India Newborn Action Plan, along with Mr. Bill Gates and Madam Melinda Gates in New Delhi. So I'm so happy, not because you have taken up this maternal and child health program. A lot of people have taken up similar issues in the government, outside the government. But the very fact that the institution, under the able leadership of all the pediatricians and scientists here, you are doing good quality research here and doing research about all the relevant aspects of the maternal health and the health of the newborn. And then, because I have always believed that if such a organized medical system, a huge, you can say, army of medical professionals all over the world, and even in India, even after 70 years of independence, if we still have one woman dying just because she became pregnant, because pregnancy, it is a blessing for a woman, it's a boon. But if it becomes a curse, I think there can't be anything more shameful than that. And if you lose a child just because you have not been able to provide the right amount of care or the facility at the right place, or if you are not able to give the right type of education to the mother. So it's a lot of things that you have taken care of, the nutrition of the mother, the eclampsia, the antenatal care, everything has been taken care of in the research aspect, because now we have reached up to a level where after which we now have to put in our best brain, the best, you can say, most sincere heart and soul into finding out the solution why we still have mortality. Because in India, you see, in most of the developed countries, I think the maternal mortality rate is just about 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4. It's not more than that. But we still have, it's more than, it's between 100 and 200. It used, 25 years, it used to be much more than that. It used to be between 400 and 800. So the very fact that this institution is doing good quality research, and then also sharing the research outcomes of your activities with the best people in the whole world, trying to learn from the research that is being done at the best places all over the world, and then the sharing of this knowledge and experience, and then planning to convert it into, translating it into action at the ground level. I think this is absolutely fantastic. And I think this goes along quite well with the vision of our very visionary Prime Minister, who has extraordinary brilliance, extraordinary ideas, who has extraordinary, I would say, commitment, dedication, sincerity, honesty, and especially for the mother, the children, for the old people, for the poor people, and he has a very, very compassionate heart. And if you look at the spending in research in the last one decade, I think it has trebled, and quite a bit of it has happened in the last For years, since the time Prime Minister Narendra Modi took place, came to the national scene, and unfortunately, as compared to what is happening inside the government, in the private sector, or in the corporate world, that much of spending is not there on the research. But I am very, very happy to see that a medical school in India is concentrating on research. This is something, unfortunately, which is really, I because I have seen from very close quarters what's happening inside the medical colleges. I think this is something which is grossly lacking in most of the medical institutions in this country. We may be doing good clinical work, we may be doing good activity in the field, but our contribution in research is probably not that much as should have been. So this place where we are doing such good quality research on such important topics, I think these are examples which can be emulated by others in this country. And I have always felt that nothing is impossible, because when I look back my 25 years and when I remind myself of the story of polio eradication, and then when I remember that 17 days after becoming the health minister in Delhi, I was addressing one of the most prestigious medical institutions in India, the Maulana Azad Medical College, on 24th of December 1994, somebody had sent a small slip to me, a pediatrician, that he wants to meet me after the program. And I said yes. And then after the program, he said, I want to take you to the one corner of the ground and I want to talk to you for 5 minutes. And then he reminded me that I should know that India is home to 60% of the polio cases of the whole world. And Delhi is home to 10% of the polio cases of those 60%. And the place where I contested my first election in public life is home to the maximum number of polio cases in the whole world. And then the Indian Academy of Pediatrics, his friends, they told me that they are running from pillar to post. And there are no takers. Everything is falling on deaf ears. Nobody listens. They say this in a country as huge as India, nothing is possible. You can't think of bringing all the children together on the same day to ensure that all this wild polio virus is replaced by vaccine virus in one single day in the intestine of the children in a country with 6 lakh villages. It's not possible. But he said, you have got a chance. Can you do it for us? And I don't know how, with the grace of God, I had a dream that night. And when I looked at the literature in the next 10 days supplied to me by the World Health Organization, I could think jolly well that if big countries in America and Brazil and others, if they can do it, why can't India do it? And when we started talking about it with small groups, with small people, everybody used to say, it's not possible, you have gone mad. But then we said, if this country can provide ballot paper to everybody on a single day, why can't this country, same country, create a cold chain and provide 2 drops of polio vaccine to every child? This is 25 years back when we used to think like that. And 25 years down the line, I feel so happy and confident that India has been able to do it. We haven't seen a case of polio for last 7 years. So all this, that we are talking about, this maternal mortality, neonatal mortality, I think all this can really be brought to zero. The only thing is that we all need to put our heart and soul into it. We have to come out of the routine box in which we always think. Out of the box, proactive, dynamic, put in all our knowledge and apply it in the best possible manner, and also then the outcomes you translate into action. The government and the private system, they all work together, and the experience of polio eradication all over the world, and its success has shown that all agencies all over the world, I remember 2014, USAID people are also here. I had the chance to address a big, huge gathering in New York, which was organized for this maternal and child health with the help of USAID. So in polio and many other similar exercises, we have seen the whole world can work together. All the UN agencies can work together. Within the country, all the systems can work together. Academic people can work together, researchers, NGOs. Everybody has to actually get together and ensure that we deliver the best possible health to our people. We convert health into a huge social movement. And that is, I think, the long cherished dream of the World Health Organization. They thought of delivering health for all by the year 2000, and now it's almost 2018, and only about two diseases have been eradicated till now. It's smallpox and polio. We need to do more, and I can tell you that this is the most opportune time in India's history, when under Narendra Modi ji's leadership he's brought so many ambitious programs in health, and he wants the health professionals to actually, and the scientific community, to ensure that they take care of their scientific and professional social responsibility. We all owe something extraordinary to our nation in terms of our social responsibility, and that social responsibility is when we talk of and think of the people who are still deprived of the basics in this country, and whether it is in terms of health or education or the adequate amount of calories. Our average caloric intake is still about 2,250 calories, which is much less than what is required. And on most of the parameters, we need to work very hard. But this is the time to rise to the occasion, because Prime Minister also wants all of us to have a dream to deliver a new India to this huge country of 125 crore Indians, a new India by the year 2022, where we get rid of all these basic problems which we are still suffering, and we bring back smiles on the faces of all the mothers, all the children, and all the newborns. I'm sure that efforts like this are going to be a great stepping stone. They have the potential to be recorded in history in future times, and I'll ensure that whatever deliberations take place here, if I am apprised of all that, I'll take them to different parts of the country through my scientific community, and ensure that whatever research is required, because in science and technology, we do the high-ended research of what we used to do in medicine. We got the rotavirus there, developed by our scientists, and which is now part of the universal immunization program, which is taking care of deaths due to diarrhea and all. So we have a lot of, challenges and grand challenges ahead of us. But together we can, I think, solve most of them, and the success of programs like smallpox and polio eradication gives us the confidence that even India, such a vast country with a lot of gross lack of resources and manpower, can still do it, because we inherit a great ancient wisdom, a great DNA from our ancestors, and I think we have all that in our DNA. I'm sure we'll be able to do it. Finally, as an environment minister, I would appeal all of to all of you that we have developed a list of 500 green good deeds within our ministry, brainstorming with people, because when we talk of environment to people and we say, what are you going to do for the environment? Most of the people will start from planting a tree and then stop at that. But I think there are hundreds of great green good deeds that one can do, and we are appealing to people all over the country to fulfill their green social responsibility towards the society and towards the country, and for having the restoring to the nature the environment which we inherited from our ancestors, because that's our moral duty for those unborn children. And I'm sure that we'll all, being a green campus and with a green approach, you will certainly look at these green good deeds, and those who want to develop and help in the development of this movement, you can download my app Dr. Harsh Vardhan from either the Google Store or the App Store, and you'll find a list of 500 green good deeds. I'm sure you'll find them very interesting, and you'll find that none of them is difficult to actually do in your own life, and this will certainly help the cause of environment and certainly ultimately help the cause of health, which we all need desperately. Thank you so much once again, Dr. Kore, for inviting me for this great function, and all my greetings and gratitude to the very senior people from all over the world who have made it to this place. We assure them that your experience and your wisdom, we'll use them in the best possible way for our countrymen. Thank you so much. Namaskar.